class our topic is declination. What is declination? And first of all, we have to know about true meridian and magnetic meridian. We have learned these terms in our previous classes, so I am revising that. The true meridian is with reference to a true north, and the magnetic meridian is with reference to a magnetic north. It is a brief explanation, shortcut. So let's go to our topic. What is declination? The true meridian and magnetic meridian will never coincide, except in some few cases. So our declination is the horizontal angle subtended in between the true meridian and the magnetic meridian is called a declination. It will be a east declination or west declination. It depends on that meridian, magnetic meridian, either it is from east to the true meridian or west to the true meridian. It depends on the magnetic meridian, either it is east or it will be west. This is our declination. How we can find out? It is find out in a place. First we have to find out a true meridian or true bearing with the help of astronomical surveys, and gradually we can find out the magnetic bearings. So the difference is we can find out the declination at that point. These are, and the declination is not same at a point and at a time at the same place. For example, if a declination is 5 degrees east at Magnagar at summer, it is not same in winter or in rainy season or in other year. Suppose it is 2019 or 2030, it will change. Either it will reduce or increase. It is not same. So, what is the isochronic lines? The lines are drawn, or the lines at which the same declination will present is called isochronic lines. And what is harmonic lines? The lines are drawn at which the declination is zero is called a harmonic lines. And the variations as we shown up, variation in declination. What are the variations? Singular variation, annular variation, diurnal variation, and irregular variation. What is a singular variation? The magnetic meridian acts like a pendulum. It will swing like a pendulum, and for the long term, 100 to 150 years, it will deflect in one direction and then come to rest and deflect in other directions. This is called a singular variation. What is the annual variation? Throughout a year, what is the variation? If you observe throughout a year, what is the variation in the declination? It is like 1 to 2 minutes average, the mean. That is called annual variation. And if we observe for a day or 24 hours, it is called daily variation or diurnal variation. Sometimes earthquake happens and some other things, natural disaster will happen. By that, irregular variations will occur. That is, sudden change in the declination is called our irregular variations. What is the relation between the true bearing and the magnetic bearing? The relation is true bearing is equals to magnetic bearing plus or minus declination. Positive sign is used when the declination is east, and the negative sign is used when the declination is west. So let's see an example. The magnetic bearing is given and the declination is given as 10 degrees 30 minutes west, and the magnetic bearing is 125 degrees 30 minutes. So as per our formula, true bearing is magnetic bearing plus the declination is given as west, so we have to detect that value. First we can draw a figure. So it is a magnetic meridian. And and this is our 135 degrees line, point suppose A. 135 degree 30 minutes. This is our 135 degree 30 minutes, and the declination is given as 10 degrees 30 minutes west. That is this angle. This angle is 10 degrees 30 minutes. By seeing the figure, we can tell us we have to deduct the value of from left side, that is the declination value. What we have to know, we have to tell that what is the this bearing from true north. So true bearing is equals to 135 degrees 30 minutes minus 10 degrees 30 minutes, that is equals to 125 degrees. That is our true bearing. Let's see an example too. In this, the magnetic bearing is given in a reduced bearing system and the declination is east. For our conveniency, we have to convert this reduced bearing to whole circle bearing. And what is the whole circle bearing value? If you don't know how to convert it, see our previous videos, then you can got the idea how to convert. Then this is our 148 degrees, and what we have said, if the declination is east, we have to add, then true bearing is equals to 148 degrees plus 8 degrees 15 minutes, that is equals to 156 degrees 15 minutes. These are how to convert if the magnetic bearing is given in a reduced bearing system. What is tip? Declination is a horizontal angle and tip is a vertical angle made by the magnetic needle with respect to a horizontal plane or horizontal magnetic flux. It is called as a tip. Okay, the vertical angle made by the needle with respect to horizontal plane is called as tip, and the declination is a horizontal angle subtended between the magnetic bearing and the true bearing. Tip is at equator it is 0 and at poles it is 90. It is like this. At equator it is 0, that is it is completely horizontal, and at poles it is 90 degrees. And it is 90 degrees. So this is a tip. It is a vertical angle made by the needle with respect to horizontal plane. There are two types of compass. The one is surveyor compass, and another one is prismatic compass. Let's see surveyor compass. With the help of surveyor compass, we can measure the reduced bearings, and the bar and the graduated needle graduation scale, and the box is fixed and the needle is free to move. And without the help of a tripod, we can't measure any angles. And the last point is the needle is a bar and edge type needle. The plan, we can see that north and south has 0 degrees and east and west has 90 degrees. This is our surveyor compass. The next one is prismatic compass. In this compass, we can measure whole circle bearings, and the needle and the graduation scale is attached and the box is free to move. And the third one is we can measure the bearings without a tripod. For example, in our phones we have a compass, that is prismatic compass. The needle is a bar type needle, and the graduations in this compass is, this is the graduation of a prismatic compass. In this, we have at the south we have 0 and at the north we have 180, and West has 90 and East has 270. If we see these graduations with the prism, we can see directly a correct readings. The graduations are taken in this composite with the help of a prism, so that they are graduated the readings as 0 at south and north as 180. If we see in the prism, we can get a correct line. And the example of these composites are four compass. Do this question, and if you have any queries, post in a comment. And thanks for watching video. Please like, subscribe and share the video.